Many of you have been anxiously waiting for this video, so hereby I bring you the 1 month update on this huge natural saltwater ecosphere. As soon as I got home from my holidays after 3 weeks, I noticed that some of the seaweed was moving. Upon closer inspection, I saw it was a big crab. I grabbed my camera to have some proof in case he would disappear again. More on him later on in this video. A lot of you seemed concerned that this ecosphere would crash in just a few days, leaving nothing but death inside. Fortunately, that is far from the truth. In fact, there's more life in this closed ecosystem than ever before. There has been an incredible growth in the populations of copepods and other crustaceans, and quite a few new species have appeared. All those even smaller white dots you see are little animals as well. You can see it even better at night, when I press the light against the glass, as many crustaceans are positively phototactic, meaning they're attracted to light. They are swarming in front of the lamp, and if you look closely, you can distinguish different species by their movement. If I move the light, you can see them following it. This makes me feel strangely powerful. I'll speed it up just a little bit. I just can't resist doing it one more time. It's just fascinating to watch. As some of you have predicted, the sea lettuce started to die and decompose as a result of a lack of water movement. Luckily, the copepods and other crustaceans have been doing a great job at processing it. Together with algae and dead critters, this is probably a big part of the diet of some crustaceans. You can see them walking all over it. This plant is also decaying, but some string algae is taking its place. Some plants and algae, however, are doing great, like this moss ball or whatever it is. I still haven't figured it out yet. It has probably doubled in size in just 1 month. This piece of solidified algae is also looking beautiful and has been growing a lot. This is actually a Gracilaria vermiculophila, an invasive species originating from the coast of China, Korea, Vietnam and Japan. It was first spotted in the Netherlands in 1980. It probably came here through oyster transport. It was spotted in France in 1996. It appeared on the east coast of the United States in 1999 and spread to the Mediterranean Sea in 2008. Did you see him? This crab has grown a lot. Judging by the shape of its carapace, the back shield, its color, its eyes, and the fact that his back two legs are flattened and have hairs on both sides, we can conclude that this crab is a Leocarcinum arcuatus, with its beautiful eyelashes. But are you ready to be amazed? The crab you're looking at is this crab. You can see that it has grown a lot in just a month. It probably grew about 100 times in volume. It's even bigger than the other crab ever became. It unfortunately died because it was already weakened, which is why I was able to accidentally catch it. This crab has been feeding off algae, little crustaceans, plankton, and probably even the dead crab. I just want to emphasize that I didn't put the crabs and starfish in this ecosphere on purpose. Luckily, this species of crab doesn't get really big, but if I get the chance, I will release it. Saltwater copepods look quite a bit different than freshwater ones. The big antennas, which it swims with, are way bigger. Possibly because salt water is more dense than fresh water. I feel like it has been a while since we did some slow-mo. We also, as always, have quite a few mysteries. That thing in the middle, for instance, is that a worm, some sort of hydra, or just a batch of eggs? And are these saltwater equivalents of Cartesian polypinum? They don't seem to contract when disturbed. I have also no idea what kind of crustacean this is. This one's a bit bigger. This looks like some sort of maggot or larvae. There's a mystery tunnel. That's about it for this update on the saltwater ecosphere. As you can see, it is doing quite well and it contains lots of life. It will be very interesting to see how long this ecosphere can survive. If you want to see more updates and other projects, well, you're going to have to subscribe. Thanks for watching.